Real quick, Edmund, I said that Mendel, Adina Mendel is going to be showing up on Kohaku tonight. That is incorrect. I was confused. It's actually going to be Meijay. Meijay did the Japanese. She speaks English as well, though, but she did the pop version of the Let It Go song out here in Japanese. So she's going to be performing. Not so even the seiyuu, the person that played Elsa in the Japanese version of Frozen, she's not singing it tonight. She might be pregnant or something, but it's going to be Meijay performing the Let It Go song tonight. She actually went to the same university that I went to in Tokyo. So there you go. All right. Always got to give you the correct facts. We're not Fox News. Ladies and gentlemen, what's up? What's up? Akasan here with another honest reaction, and it is New Year's Eve, about 8 o'clock. Time to bring in the new year. So I'm doing a little last minute request here, catching up here. I wanted to end it with one of my favorites in terms of franchises or things I reacted about this year, but this is not one of them. This is, well, actually, technically, this is one of them. Frozen. Voiceover. This is a request from John Shin. He wanted me to request he wanted me to react to this Frozen voiceover here. And for me, when I just think about the year and the way this year was, Frozen by far are out here called Ana no Yuki no Ana to Yuki no Jo, as we call it out here in Japanese in Japan. Ana to Yuki no Jo or Frozen was probably one of the biggest influences or culturally what really made 2014 by far. It has just transformed Japan in general, and so much so that Tokyo Disneyland, starting next month, is going to be releasing something called Frozen Forever, where they transform a part of Tokyo Disneyland into Arendelle and such. They are still singing Let It Go out here. And to top things off, we have basically the Super Bowl of Japan. Nothing with sports or whatever, but it's basically kind of like, I won't say American Idol, but it's like a huge talent show where they get all the biggest acts of the year. It's called a Kohaku. They bring out all the biggest acts of the year on stage, and basically if you are on that show, you did something big this year. So actually, Adina Menzel, the Frozen girl, she's actually going to be on this show tonight, as far as I know. So that's huge. That's huge news. That's a huge influence. And she has to be singing it in English, so this will be very interesting. I might stay home just to watch that. That's my life. All right, I've talked so much. Let's see what Frozen voiceover is all about. Pop me up for 2014, and here we go.
Queen Elsa of Arendelle.
Princess Anna. Hold up, y'all, I'm on my way. Hold up, don't stop without me. I'm the motherfucking princess. Oh. Hey. Okay, I'm gonna be so pushy and rude. Damn, okay.
Oh my god. Sorry. I heard you.
No, no,
me? Oh no. I didn't fight, did you? You crazy. What do you mean you're crazy? I mean, there's a lot of things that can happen to you. I mean, there's a lot of food and wine and everything.
It happens.
Oh. You see, that's how you do it. You know what it smells like in here?
I know what it smells like in here. Wait.
It smells like ass. Oh my gosh, you have to dance with my sister Anna. This is her song.
Yeah, you know how to. What?
Oh, hell no!
Bitch, I'm gonna find your ass!
Oh, I remember back in my day. I was getting pictures like you. Not the back. All the hoes trying to hit on me, trying to get the deep.
I can give you some of the deep. You go upstairs, man.
We're not gonna move those crazy ass. Come on, hoes. Let me take you there.
Oh!
This nigga be dancing all over me like a fucking parakeet.
I'm just trying to let you have some fun.
Yeah. Oh, bitch, please. You look great. Yeah. I felt like it was the man from the fucking Jumanji movie. I'm so serious. I feel like you need a man.
Jumanji, but yeah.
Fuck you.
Well, that's what you get. You smell like shit. I see how it is. Long nights, long nights to get a payday. Finally got paid. Watch out, shit. Oh.
Don't worry, I got you.
And you're sexy as hell. Ooh. Damn, now where the hell have you been? I've been dancing with motherfuckers up in here making me look like Sacagawea.
What?
California.
Alright. That wasn't bad, the voiceover. It's all good. Dang, that has 368,000 views. See, what I will say, there's no doubt that was funny. Could have been a little better. Could timing, you know. I think because I watch so many of these types of videos or whatever, like, especially when you got people like Team 4 Star doing some hardcore stuff, like full-fledged episodes sometimes. Team 4 Star, there's a few other, actually, which is ironic, the dude that the real 85 videos or something, the dude that does the Nigga Turtles, like, you can really tell the difference between the two. So, you know, it wasn't bad, though. Definitely, probably, just could have been a little bit more timing. A little more work. It would have been really, really good. Man, it almost makes me want to, If I felt like I could do it, like, just if I had the right knack for, like, I don't know, you definitely would have to feel it. In terms of, like, yes, I could definitely make something like this funny or whatever. Like, that's what's always stopped me from doing voiceovers. So, like, these kind of parody voiceovers. But, oh, man, that would be something funny, though. And the other thing is they probably should have just done it in higher definition. I don't know why they chose such a bootleg VHS-looking copy or whatever. You know, but still, it was pretty funny, but some parts I could see it wasn't like they just needed to throw in an obligatory fuck you like that. But nevertheless, it was all good. You know, I have actually done. I've had some of my students do the Aladdin voiceover, just word by word. They've done it, and that's been pretty cool. Man, I should do one. I should. If anybody out there knows. Of someone out there, like, I wanted to audition. There was a dude, he was doing like a Batman abridged, and I wanted to audition as Batman, but I don't know what happened. I don't think that dude actually ended up doing anything at all. That's the main thing, it's all the editing. But I really wanted to audition as Batman and be that dude's Batman and the abridged thing he was doing, but I don't know if it ever worked out. But yeah, man, I got a mic and everything set up, so if you guys know someone who needs voiceover work, I'm down for that. Alright, that's enough. Sorry, I made this one a little longer than it should have, but not bad. Frozen, not bad. There's actually a few of them. I might have to look around. Thanks, John. Appreciate it. Until the Batman vs. Superman trailer comes out, I shall stay frosty and frozen and always keep my reactions honest. Let the storm rage on! Fuck you.